people often say, well, how do I prioritize? And I say, well, until you have the whole inventory of everything you need to do at all these horizons, it's going to be tough to prioritize. So the simple answer is you need to hardwire your intuitive judgments internally about, you know, what's important to you in life and where you're going. And that shows up in at least 6 different levels. Why are you on the planet? What's the vision you and any partners have in life about where you want to be? You know, what short term, what do you then need to accomplish to make the vision happen? What are all the parts of your life that need to be maintained so that your house and your health and your relationships to make sure that the whole engine gets there? And what are the 50 to 70 projects you've got about all that? And what are the 250 action items you need to do? Well, I just laid out for you all the discussions you're gonna need to mature and get complete about before you can possibly hope to trust you know what to do if you get 8 minutes and got a phone and got energy of 3 on a scale of 10. How on earth could you answer that question unless you had developed all those conversations and matured all of that and objectified it in a certain way? So I got 8 minutes, that one. It's ultimately gonna have to be an intuitive judgment because no system will tell you what to do. What a system and a systematic approach like GTD does, though, it moves you from hope to trust in that judgment. You'll at least see your options. And then when you look at them and go, nah, you know, I'd rather go play with my kids. At least you go play with your kids with the sense that that was more important than anything else I had to do in my life. And that was a pretty good inventory of what I just looked at, so I'm clean. That's really how this game works. So it's almost like, well, which one of those horizons do you need to work on to get that inventory clear so you can trust that when you're in the run, in the heat of battle out there? If you stop to think, you're dead. You don't have time to stop and think. You need to have already thought. Actually, just practically speaking, 95% of the time when you have the time and energy to do something, you don't have the time and energy to think about what to do. You need to have already done that. But if you wind up with the time and energy to do something, but you haven't taken the time to think about and define all the things you could do, you're missing huge opportunities to move things forward in your life with a lot less stress and a lot more ease.